gentlemen, this is your host Mihir Joshi, and this is the MJ Show. I have somebody who's back on the MJ Show after almost, almost 6 to 7 years, because the last time I had my guest who's joining me today was, I think, October 2013. And just last week, two days ago on Wednesday, I had Shalmani, who was the very first guest on the MJ Show. And the gentleman who's joining me today is an incredible music director. He is a phenomenal musician. He writes songs. There's so much that this man does. And I'm super excited to talk to him today again after, like I said, almost 7 years. Because I remember even back then, the stories that he told me, the incredible experiences that he shared with me was something that I will always remember. I think he's one of the finest storytellers that I've ever had on the show. And I'm looking forward to the things that he shares with me today. So let us have a quick look and check if our friend Kaushal Inamdar is here. I'm just going to drop him a message. That is done. All right. Oh, there you go. Jaise hi naam liya, Kaushal Inamdar is here. And I'm in our chat. And let's get ready, ladies and gentlemen, for the absolutely fabulous Kaushal Inamdar.
Kaushal. Hello there. Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, but absolutely fine.
So many years since we last met on the MJ Show, and we met in person as well. It's been a long time since we actually met up either at my place or your place or anywhere for that matter. So it's good to see you finally after so many years almost.
Same year, Mihir. Same year.
So I was just telling everybody right now that, you know, it's almost been 7 years since you last came on the MJ Show. In 2013, September is when we must have recorded, because our episode went out on the 3rd or 4th of October, if I remember correctly. It's just great to have you back. I remember one of the reasons that I really bonded and I really connected with you back then was because of your incredible soundtrack of Bal Gandharvan. Coincidentally, my 100th guest of this lockdown season, as I call it. Today, you are, by the way, my 121st guest. So my 100th guest was Anand Bhate.
And it's Bal Gandharva Jayanti today. So
exactly. So I just saw Anand had put up a video commemorating Bal Gandharva Jayanti. I had him as my 100th guest. We were talking about that phenomenal soundtrack again. And what a brilliant coincidence that I have you, the man who brought back the music of Bal Gandharva to a much larger, younger audience right now. I'm not saying that went away ever, because it's that... what do you call it? Eternal music. It's going to remain for years and centuries.
That's true.
But
that's true.
You brought it to a younger audience with the voice of somebody who I think is one of the finest singers of our country. And since you did mention today, it is Bal Gandharva's birth anniversary. Let's talk about an experience from that soundtrack. Before we talk about anything that you've done since then, you've not shared with me that time. Because I remember the amazing story you shared of how you found Anand Bhate,
yes.
Voice of Bal Gandharva. For everybody who's not seen that, please go and check out that episode. When this video goes up on the YouTube channel of the MJ Show, I'll give you a link to the first time Kaushal came, and you should hear the story of how he and Aditya Oak went to Pune, saw Anand come to a studio and got him to record something, and they just knew that this is the guy who's going to be singing Bal Gandharva soundtrack. So that story is fantastic. I kind of gave you a brief idea of what it was. But tell us something about that time, because I'm sure you have so many incredible experiences from the making of that soundtrack.
Yeah.
Share something with us.
You know, 21 songs, 9 months, and in one studio. There was a time to go to the studio, but not a time to come back. So Aditya and I especially, we spent a lot of time in the studio. The whole challenge of Bal Gandharva's soundtrack was actually not the songs by Bal Gandharva per se, because, you know, I was wise enough to take up people who knew more about Natya Sangeet than I did.
Right.
You know, so Aditya Oak was there or Anand Bhate was there. So I knew who would. For me, the challenge was that apart from Bal Gandharva's phenomenal century-old music,
correct,
I had to create 3 new songs,
correct,
in the same film,
correct,
and you know, that was a sort of that was a potential pitfall,
Correct. Because if it did
because
not stand up to the rest of the songs,
yes,
you would be in
so
terrible trouble,
yeah,
yeah.
so you know, my competition was not some contemporary music composer.
Correct.
Sorry, my competitor was 100-year-old, tried, tested, proven music of a genius.
Correct.
Okay, and so the three tracks that I did anew were, one was Aaj Mhare Ghar Paavna, that was a song written by Swanand Kirkire, and that was Swanand Kirkire's first Marathi film, by the way.
Oh, wow.
Balgandharva, so for which he wrote the lyrics. Then we did a song called Parvardigar, which was a Qawwali, okay,
Amazing
and
song.
sung by Shankar Mahadevan, and short introduction by Anand Bhatia to that song. And the
Yes.
third, which nobody, you know, I'll tell you a very nice story. When I started with Balgandharva,
Yeah.
what was the pain in my heart was that we had such a phenomenal singer, and I was born in a completely different era, so
Correct.
we couldn't even see him.
Correct.
And when Aditya and I heard hundreds of hours of recording of Bal Gandharva, that sense of missing grew even more. So I knew that I could never get Bal Gandharva to sing a song composed by me.
Correct.
So, you know, a mind with one's own interest works very curiously. I tried to find out what could be the solution to that now. I couldn't get Bal Gandharva to sing, but by some will of providence, I was making this film. So was there a chance that on screen Bal Gandharva is humming my composition? Okay, so when Ravi Jadhav said there is a situation in the film where we can use Bal Gandharva's famous bhajan Aga Vaikunthe Charaya, or another of his bhajans, so I
Right.
said, can we make a fresh song here?
Right.
So there was a song from Saumshay Kallol, and the traditional tune was Chinmaya Sakala Rudaya, Chinmaya Sakala Rudaya, Sadaya Deya Govinda, वर वरदा कलिमल दिस
अच्छा
वाज अ ट्रेडिशनल भरत वाक्य, दैट इज द लास्ट सॉन्ग ऑफ द प्ले संशय कल्लोळ.
वाह
नाउ बालगंधर्व एक्टेड इन दैट प्ले, बट ही डिडंट सिंग दिस सॉन्ग बिकॉज दिस सॉन्ग वाज फॉर अनदर कैरेक्टर.
करेक्ट
सो आई थॉट मे बी आई कुड रीवर्क ऑन दिस सॉन्ग एंड गिव द सेम वर्ड्स अ फ्रेश ट्यून
राइट
which will make it sound like Bal Gandharva's song. So I recomposed that song as Chinmaya Sakala Rudaya, Chinmaya Sakala Rudaya, Sadaya Deya Govinda, वर वरदा कली मन विनया, वर वरदा कली मन विनया, चिन्मया सकल हृदया, चिन्मया सकल हृदया. सो
वाह
आई गॉट इट संग फ्रॉम आनंद भाटे, एंड द wonder of wonders was that the film was Bal Gandharva based on his music, but all the awards that Anand got that year for was for this song. which was created anew for this film.
Correct.
And I did not leave aside an award. I did not get even a single nomination for this film for music, because
okay.
people thought this is Bal Gandharva's song.
Correct.
So the award was actually that I became so one with that music.
Unbelievable.
That the nobody on the jury of various awards, right from local channel awards to the national awards, nobody even thought that this could be a new composition. Everybody thought that this was a composition sung by Bal Gandharva.
Bal Gandharva.
Bhaskar Bua Bakhle or Govind Rao Tembe. And Anand Bhatte got every single award for this song. Even when he won the national award, it was for this song, and it was this song that he sang in the president's the president's mansion.
Right.
So it was wonderful, and it taught me a lesson that a song is its own reward.
Absolutely. And
yes,
you know what?
Yes.
Let me tell you a little story that Anand shared with me when he was on the show. He said that, you know, even today when he performs various songs from the Bal Gandharva soundtrack, the greatest joy that he gets is when people come and tell him, ki, are, Chinmaya Sakal Hridaya Bal Gandharvanni kadhi gailelo? When did he sing
Correct.
This song?
Yeah.
When most people, even today, when they hear him perform that song, assume
right.
that it it's the Bal Gandharva song which he's
right,
just
right,
performed
right.
again. I think truly that is the greatest compliment that you as a composer can also get,
and,
because that
and,
was not
and
you.
Also, Anand, and because Anand is, he's also called Gandharva.
Yep.
He's a child prodigy and he was called Anand Gandharva. So,
correct.
To that. You know, there is no greater reward than having people who are geniuses and truly celestial geniuses sing your songs. So, what can be a greater award than that?
Absolutely.
And,
absolutely.
So, there were a lot of people who asked me, so do you miss that getting an award? I said,
okay.
No, because I learned a lesson which was greater than any award, and that was that making a song is its own reward. There is no bigger sense of satisfaction, no bigger sense of delight and bliss than making a song with people who are. So it's like it's like the prayer that let me be always in the company of Pratibhavanta people. People
nice.
Who are blessed. So
correct.
That was a great.
How is it actually said in Marathi? What is this prayer?
No, Tukaram has said no. Ki sada sant sant gati labho. No, what was that? It's from Hechi Dana Dega Deva. That
okay.
Let me be in the company of saints.
Lovely. By the
Let
way, for everybody watching, for everybody watching right now and whoever will watch this later on, if you're wondering, and I've said this when I spoke with Anand, when I spoke with Rahul, when I spoke with Mahesh, and when I recently spoke with somebody, with Shalmali, that both of us talking right now are Maharashtrians. We can obviously communicate in Marathi, but we don't want to limit our conversation only to the people who understand Marathi. And we recognize that whether it's in India or people watching outside of India, the most universally
right.
understood language is English, which is why we are predominantly speaking in English, while we will obviously
right.
land up speaking two words in Marathi. So that's not an insult to Marathi, because in fact, if anything, the man I'm speaking to right now has written one of the greatest songs in praise of the Marathi language. And for fans of Tamil Nadu, you already know that. But for those of you who do not know that, my homework to you is, and I'll give it to you as a link under this video as well, check out what a song that he wrote called the Marathi Abhiman Geet, which will now complete what, 7-8 years? Kiti
varsha? No,
10 years. Wow, it's been 10 years since we met as well.
Yeah,
that means.
Yeah. Actually, I always say that, Marathi Abhiman Geet is a song not only for people who speak Marathi, or whose mother tongue is Marathi, it's a song for all those people who have a mother tongue.
Correct.
And also, I am willing to praise my mother tongue in any language of the world. So if I have to praise Marathi in English, so be it. If I have to praise Marathi in Hindi, I will do that. You know,
Absolutely.
because Amruta te paisa jinkhnari bhasha hai. So it doesn't need my my ratification that because I speak in Marathi, it's such a great language. I
That's true.
just heard Professor Ashok Bagwe's brilliant enunciation of the Pasayadan and why Jnaneshwari was written in Marathi. You know, and how he calls Jnaneshwar calls Marathi the language that will win a wager with even the celestial nectar. So
Wow.
I love languages. I love Marathi because it is my own. I feel I find myself in Marathi.
Right.
It
That's
doesn't mean
beautiful.
that I have any. I love actually I love languages because it, you know, just speaking another language, understanding it gives us a different perspective about.
Correct.
And I love other languages because my mother tongue is Marathi. That
That's lovely. Yeah.
whole broad attitude towards languages was developed because my mother tongue is Marathi. So I'm indebted to my mother tongue.
That's really, really cool. So, I realize that we spent our first 15 minutes talking about something which we had kind of begun speaking almost 7 years ago. But now let's talk about everything that's happened since then. There's a lot of music that you've made, a lot of great content that you've created, whether it's on your YouTube or your Facebook or for films or plays. So, let's talk about some of the important, let's call them milestone moments in these last 7 years. And I would like to actually ask you, can you share with us some of the, because I told everybody before you came, and I told you as well, that I think you're one of the finest storytellers. So rather than me prompting you, I would love to hear some stories in the last 7 years that have meant a lot to you, some important moments of your career.
My Facebook bio is that I am a storyteller in the disguise of a musician. Music is my way of telling a story, but
Lovely.
in the heart of my hearts, I am a storyteller. My career started with writing, actually. I started writing for television, and I apprenticed with a great director in Hindi films called Lake Tandon ji. So that's how I started. But my first guru who taught me was Chetan Datar, who was a playwright. And so I feel that music is a wonderful way of telling a story. And in these 7 years, I have, you know, I don't. I'm not such a I'm not a person in hurry, so I don't want in 7 years, if you see the amount of work that I may have done will definitely be less than people who are my contemporaries, but I have done some wonderful work and
I agree.
some wonderful moments I have got because of that. So I did a few films. I did after Bal Gandharva, I did Ajanta. Then I did that was brilliant because I think Hamsika is watching, and
Hamsika is watching, yes.
Hamsika, like Anand Bhate won all the awards that year for Bal Gandharva. Hamsika won all the awards that year for the best playback singing for Ajanta.
Agenda.
For her Manachimba Pavasadi. I would like her to sing if she's there, and you can
So she's
call her
here,
later
and I'm
on.
gonna for everybody watching, Hamsika is already watching us right now, but I'm gonna get her on in a little while from now. We're gonna spend about another 20 minutes with Kaushal, and then we're gonna get Hamsika on for 20 minutes, and we'll talk about some of the things right now, and hopefully we'll get Hamsika to sing us a few songs as well. So, which song you know?
This was Manu Chimba Pavasari from Ajanta.
Right.
And then I partnered with Hamsika for, you know, a band called Rasa Yatra. And we have been doing those shows for a number of years, on and off. But we love working with each other. You know, I feel that she's my musical soulmate. It's I don't have to explain to her what I have in mind. And she sings much better than... It's like she knows my music better than I do.
Wow.
So it's with that feeling that she sings. So we did Rasa Yatra, for which I did some compositions. And we had a brilliant time. So I did Kabir, I did Mahadevi Verma, I did some of my own songs, some songs that I wrote.
That was one of the songs I shared today, right? Bige Bige.
That's right. So that was a song that I wrote and composed. And then I did a film called Yellow in these after Ajanta. And that was a different for me because it was rock music, Mihir. And Apeksha Dandekar sang the song for it.
Abhijit
Gupta sang the song. So for 6 months, I heard nothing but rock. So Evanescence and Coldplay, and my son was very happy because he's a rock fan. So then Imagine Dragons and all the stuff that I wouldn't have otherwise heard.
How
and
cool.
I did two songs for Yellow. And then some very different music for a film called Ranga Patanga. And that was a different challenge because I had to compose one lyric in two different tunes. So I think I remember today is even Madan Mohan's is it death anniversary or it's birth anniversary? I don't remember. So Madan Mohan has done it for Mausam, that Dil Dhoondta Hai in two different tunes he has done. Dil Dhoondta Hai Phir Wohi Fursat Ke Raat Din. Dil Dhoondta Hai. And Dil Dhoondta Hai Phir Wohi Fursat Ke Raat Din. So same words but two tunes. And
two tunes.
That was what I did in Ranga Patanga. There is a Ghazal and a Qawwali, same words. Sanam aankhon ko meri khoobsurat saaz de. Sanam aankhon ko meri khoobsurat saaz de. Ye uni swapnat maajha ekda aawaz de. Sanam. So this was one tune. And ऐ सनम आँखों को मेरी खूबसूरत ख्वाब साज दे. ऐ सनम आँखों को मेरी खूबसूरत साज दे. ये उनी स्वप्नात माझा एक दावाज दे. ऐ सनम. That was a cover.
Wow.
So Chan. The same words, and it was a bilingual ghazal by Ilahi Zamadar. So
how
fantastic.
Cool.
And then of course came the film Ubuntu, for which I composed this brilliant prayer by Samir Samant. And I'll tell you that there are some moments of you know, total satisfaction that you can't get by asking. And that is what songs give you. This song, mm-hmm. हीच मुझी प्रार्थनान हेच मुझे मागणे माणसाने माणसाशी माणसास मागणे हीच मुझी प्रार्थना. दिस सॉन्ग इज नाउ it traveled so far and wide, the song, that it's a song many schools in Maharashtra have adopted it as their official prayer.
Oh, wow.
The university has adopted this as an official prayer. And a wonderful experience that I had was that there was an interview of a rickshaw driver in one of the newspapers a few months back. And, you know, he came into Vogue because twice it happened with him that somebody left a bag full of currency notes in his rickshaw and he returned it.
Wow.
He returned the bag. Twice it happened. So, you know, this very honest rickshaw driver was interviewed by the journalist in question. And the journalist asked him, what is it that inspired you, you know, to
return
behave with such honesty and return the bag to its rightful owner? And he said that every morning when I leave my house, I listen to this prayer, Hi cha mujhe prarthana an he cha mujhe magne. And I feel that I have to become a better person. Now, what more do you want from a song? And that is why I believe that music is not just entertainment. I see people on Twitter, you know, saying that you are just singing in times of corona, and you know, but that is, music is, it's not entertainment. It touches people's lives. It changes people's lives. It gives them inspiration. It gives them a reason to stay alive.
Absolutely.
It's not a coincidence that most of our freedom fighters went to the gallows singing songs.
That's true.
They did
true.
Not
oh,
go
man.
There espousing philosophy.
Correct. You know,
they sang songs on the gallows. That is the strength of music. And I totally believe it. I have great faith in music. I might question the existence of God, but music is my point of faith.
That's amazing. I have got goosebumps throughout this entire conversation. Just check this out. I can't even fake this.
Yeah.
And, you know, it just made me remember something. Rahul Deshpande said this at the end of my chat with him. I had him just before Anand on the same night. Aaj apan je kela na, that was music for me. This conversation was, in a sense, music for me. Music is not just notes that you play, but it's the melody that you create through emotions and through talking and through, you know,
that's
just expressing.
True.
And honestly, that for me, I mean, the closest that I have felt to something divine is through music. What you just
that's
said, like, you know what, honestly, I was expecting this to happen today, that there would be something that you would tell me, just a conversation piece that would happen where I'd get goosebumps. And this, you just made that happen. And you know, when I see this and when I see the incredible amount of work, you know, good work that you've done and that you're continuing to do on your YouTube, on your social media, on Facebook, I wanted to ask you something which seems a little... not unfair to you, but unfair in my mind to the work that you've created, which is, now if you look at, you know, people who've got YouTube channels, you know, YouTubers and others, there are people with hundreds and thousands of subscribers, you know, and they put out as whatever, 1 million views and 5 million views and whatever else.
That's
or, you know, at you most singers nowadays think, unless my video has at least got like 100,000 views,
right.
And today I heard the song which I shared with everybody on my Instagram story. It's truly a spectacular song. And I can't believe that that song right now, after having released it almost a year ago, has under 1,000 views. Now, I have never asked anybody a question which I feel could make them uncomfortable. And I am asking you because I know you're not uncomfortable about this, because I know you're focused on the quality of the content and the work rather than the numbers it is generating, because we all know the game right now. Everybody knows the game. The moment you market your products and you know, you do spend money behind it, it will be seen and you will get your numbers of views.
Right.
That said, does it bother you? I want to understand, you know, because I see your work and it is exceptional. Today I was also seeing a video in which you talked about the anatomy of a song and, you know, how you understand the sense of a song. And I loved the things that you were saying in that video. And that is content I wish more and more people who love music would watch and would understand how important, you know, things like that are to appreciating music even better. I was watching it on your YouTube channel. By the way, I'm going to give a link to Kaushal's YouTube channel. Everybody watching, please go and subscribe to his YouTube channel and watch his videos, even if they're in Marathi. That, by the way, is something that I would recommend to you. You should definitely ask some friend of yours to maybe transcribe your content.
Actually, I have already
subtitles.
Lot of my friends have, now they're pitching in for making the subtitles and transcribing it into English. So there are one or two. This video that you are talking about, so there are two or three people who have actually transcribed it. I'm just, you know, picking which is the best version. Translation, or if I can mix the versions of people. But there are many people. Manjusha Sawant, who owns the website called Geeta Manjusha. There is a Facebook friend called Archana Namjoshi. Then Nikhil Bedekar, I think. I'm very sorry. Dharap. Nikhil Dharap has done. So there are many friends, you know, who volunteered to do this community translations. And the question that whether it bothers me, yes, it does.
I can imagine.
Bother me that. Yeah. Not to the point where I'll get cynical or pessimistic, because that's not what I am at all. From the beginning, I have worked in a very niche sort of areas. And I have always had people who said that you should do something which is, you know, which will make you more popular. But I understand, I get their sincere wishes. And sometimes I wish, yes, I was, you know, there were more numbers on my YouTube channel. But the problem with me is that I'm not looking at my music. I get bored with myself more than anybody else can ever hope to. So I don't want to repeat myself. So I keep on moving. So if you have noticed, I don't have a style of music.
Correct.
Okay. So you see, Balgandharva is totally different from what I did in Ajanta. Then what I did in Yellow was totally different from what I did in Balgandharva, for example. I did Ranga Patanga, which is totally different from Ubuntu. And so I kept on, I'm still finding myself. Music is my way of understanding myself.
Wow.
So, yes, it bothers me why there are no views or less views sometimes to the songs which actually deserve to be. I always tell myself that, you know, there is a definition of democracy by Lincoln that we all know, that democracy is a rule of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from this earth. You know that in Gettysburg Address he said that. But there is another definition by George Bernard Shaw, who says democracy is a device which ensures that you shall be governed no better than you deserve.
Okay.
There will be a time when people deserve some good music and they will come to it. It's there wow. on YouTube. It's available. Sometime people will discover it and yeah, I care about numbers, but I don't care more about numbers than the quality of life that I'm living.
Beautiful.
So that if they increase, I'll be very happy. I'm not denying that charm of, you know, being popular. I would love to be popular. Correct. I would love to be more Correct. Popular than I am. But I won't sacrifice it at the altar of doing what I want to do.
I agree completely. Kaushal, I'm interrupting you just to say that I resonate with you so strongly on this because this August, 1st of August, the MJ Show will complete 7 years. And very often I get the similar kind of feedback as well. For people who watch the content, when they see it, they're like, oh my God, this is such a great interview of this artist or that artist. And, you know, I genuinely believe that every piece of content that I have created, whether it's with you or it's with Sonu Nigam or it's with KK or it's with Javed Bashir or whoever else, I believe in that content. I believe in the content and the quality.
You are such a happy person.
Yeah, exactly. I love that about you. No, and I knew you would understand my question and not be offended by it because I feel the same about my work. I feel that, you know, I often say this, that if you walk into a mall and you ask 1,000 people, how many of you know Coffee with Karan? I'd say 950 people will say, yes, I know. Yeah. How many of you see MJ Show? I'd be surprised if maybe 10 out of 1,000 people will say that they know the MJ Show. But, you know, I'm content with the fact that, you know, I'm still not sacrificing the quality of the work that I'm trying to do or not doing stuff just to get the numbers. You know, I can see it's easy to do gimmicky content which has the ability to go viral or, you know, for people to share. Like if I got you to do something very unexpected, there's a very good possibility that people will be like, "Arey, Kaushal Inamdar doing," if I asked you to rap a song right now and it's not your I wouldn't do that, but I'm saying if I did things like that, or if I said, "All right, chalo, let's do a Balgandhar song, but do it in a rap style." That's not the essence of what I do or the essence of what you do. So why would I want to do that? That's how I've always felt about my work. I want that the person who I speak to goes back out of this conversation feeling, I'm happy. I'm content with having this conversation. So, and the proof, and I say this as in solidarity with you is, despite not having millions of subscribers, despite not having millions of views on every video, every singer in the industry, every artist in the industry wants to come and have a talk with me.
I don't doubt that at all.
That is my biggest compliment that I can get. That I have never promised a singer that, you know, hey, you come on my show and if I promote your song, next day your song will get 10,000 views or you will get 5 million subscribers, you know, 5,000 subscribers or 500 subscribers or whatever. I don't have the power right now to give myself views and subscribers. I will never commit that to anyone. But I have this much that I can promise, that if you come and talk to me, I will give you the best conversation that you can have about your content that you want to really talk about. I'm not going to play games. I'm not going to fool around with you. If you come to talk to me about a song, we will talk about that song. We will get into it. We will get behind the story of it. And for me, that has been my biggest joy. And I know that someday in the future, when kids want to know about the music of this generation, they will look at my videos as study material. If they wanted to know about the stories of the artists of this generation, I'm chronicling that for them for the future. Even if now I don't have the
truth.
And I genuinely believe that about your content. And I promise you, I did not ask you the question so that I could give you this answer. I'm giving it to you because I resonate with you. And I know that your music is beautiful. And I know that your music is timeless. And it will be recognized for what it is, even if it's not right now. But, you know, 10 years down the line or 50 years down the line. So, you know, I'm really happy. I'm really happy that you made such unbelievable and great songs. Like I said, the song that I shared this afternoon deserves far more recognition and love than it has got right now. And I meant to everybody watching, I'm going to give you a link to that song also in the description of this video when it goes up on YouTube.
please do that. Yeah.
Swipe up link on Instagram. Please go and watch that song that Hamsika has sung. And that Kaushal has not only composed, but you've also written that song, right?
Yeah. I've written that song. So we'll ask Hamsika when you get her, we'll ask her to sing that song actually.
We'll ask her to sing that song for sure. You know what? I don't want to let you go. I had planned that, you know, we'll talk for about 40 minutes and I'll get Hamsika on. I still want to talk a little bit more with you. What I can do with Hamsika, because Instagram ka ek ghante mein automatically band ho jata hai. So Hamsika, if you're watching right now, what I'll do is, let me complete this chat with Kaushal for however long it goes. And we'll start a new chat with you afresh, which I'm sure Kaushal will still stay and watch.
Yeah, sure.
We can start a new chat with you. So we are not limited to that 15-20 minute window. We can have a slightly longer chat with Hamsika as well.
Right,
so Kaushal, now that we've gotten this part of our story out of the way, what have you been busy with during these 3 months where everybody has been at home?
Right. I have been teaching at the Film and Television Institute of India for past 4 years now. And I've been teaching to the direction and editing students there. And I take a class on music appreciation and on background scores. So when I knew that, you know, next 6 to 8 months, maybe even a year, it's going to be difficult for musicians. Because there will be no concerts, or even if they are, they'll be seriously handicapped with, people attending, the number of people attending, the number of people on stage. And for people like me, it's going to be even more difficult, because as it is, we are working in niche areas.
Okay.
So, it's not like that my YouTube channel is going to give me a lot of... So, what I thought was, because it's important to keep me going on my own terms. So, I thought that I would design a course for listeners on music appreciation. So I did this online. I am still doing online courses in music appreciation, especially the Indian film song. You listen to a song and you say like it. You like the song, but you don't know why you like it.
Correct.
So this workshop is to understand your own liking.
Wow.
And also, because, you know, a lot of people say that we like music, but we don't understand it. Okay.
Correct.
So it's not true, actually. You like it because you understand it.
Correct.
It's the only thing is that you can't give the reason for, you can't crystallize your understanding. You
Correct.
Can't articulate it. So
Correct.
I, with this workshop, it's called Anatomy of a Song. I try to, articulate what exactly you have understood from a song. It's
right.
not possible for you not to understand, because the music composer is finding ground, a common ground with you to communicate.
Lovely.
So if it is communication and you like it, that means you understand. Now,
Correct.
You don't realize that you have understood. That is a mystery of the human mind.
Wow.
Okay. So I'm trying to just demystify that.
That's amazing.
How you have understood. For example.
And how can people take part in this class of yours?
Yeah. My Facebook page. Or on my Instagram also. But more on, I'm more active on Twitter and Facebook. So
right.
I give the, so far more than 150 people have done, and Hamsika and I conduct that workshop. Hamsika is a
awesome.
Very enthusiastic moral support for me in that, though I do the talking, but she sings in that workshop also. And we have done now the two workshops. One we have just completed last weekend was only for people in USA. And the next workshop next weekend on 11th and 12th is also going to be the same. But I keep announcing and I have taken 7 batches so far. More than 150 people have done this workshop. Very happy. I'm glad that, you know, it ignites that curiosity of you start at looking like each song like a thriller.
Lovely.
You know, like what is, can you divulge that mystery of that song?
That's amazing.
And you divulge the mystery without losing the romance.
That's awesome.
That is what we attempt to do in this.
That's brilliant. Tell me one of the songs that you have sort of dissected in this, because I'm going to ask Hamsika to maybe hum a line or two of that song as well. Just give me an example.
Okay. So, today being, I don't know, Madan Mohan's this.
By the way, when you mentioned that, I checked it up. It was yesterday. Yeah, 25th June 1924 was his birthday. Yeah. And 14th July 1975 was his death. So we've just one day after his birthday.
Yeah.
Birth anniversary. Yeah.
So, for example, his famous song. Teri aankhon ke siwa duniya mein rakha kya hai, ye uthe subah chale, ye jhuke shaam dhale, mera jeena mera marna inhi palkon ke tale. So this, now I'm doing a very short version of what I do in the workshop, but let me tell you. You say sare ga ma pa dha ni sa is going up, right? Or you say that I'm going far. Sare ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. You are coming close. Now everybody identifies with this imagery. Nobody says, when I say sare ga ma pa dha ni sa, nobody will say that I'm coming down. So you understand, right?
Correct.
Now, this is the premise which Madan Mohan has taken, and then he will say, ye uthe subho chale. So, uthe, upar ya niche? Upar hai na? So, ye uthe subho chale, right? Jhuke, niche hai. Ye jhuke, but subho ke aage shaam hai. Shaam dhale. So, ye uthe subho chale sare ga, ye jhuke shaam dhale sare ga ma. And mera jeena mera marna. So, if we say that an octave, the lower sa is the beginning.
The jeena.
The upper sa is the destination. So, if jeena is the whole life is an octave. You know, you see this imagery. Now, and marna is the destination. So, where will it be? Mera jeena, mera marna sa. But where? Kaha hai mera jeena, mera marna? Wahi palko ke tale. So, where it will be? The lower sa. Mera jeena, mera marna inhi palko ke tale sa. And you return back to home.
Wow.
So, now, you don't have to be told that this is sa. But when you see mera jeena, mera marna sa, and you know that there is some kind of a finality to it, right? So that is the destination. Now you take this song onto any other note. Mera jeena, mera marna. It sounds incomplete.
That's
mera
true.
Jeena, mera marna. Sounds like
that's
you're
true.
Taking a halt.
Kya
mera
baat
jeena,
hai?
Mera marna. As if you want to go somewhere, but mera jeena, mera marna. So that is
that's true.
See, any work of art or any song, especially, is a journey from the possible to the inevitable.
Wow.
Once Madan Mohan starts with a premise that mera jeena, mera marna is an octave, he has no other alternative but to use that sa. And that is a genius of a composer who understands that inevitability of that sur. There is no other option. There is no other alternative. And that is a good composition.
Amazing.
That's why you say, wah, kya baat hai.
Unbelievable. Oh man, I want to be a part of these sessions when you're dissecting the song. I would love to watch them. That is so cool. By the way, for everybody watching, guys, this is what I was talking about. You know, if you wondered why I went into this tirade, which I never often do, I mean, never do in any of my shows, is because I wanted to tell you that this is the person or this is the content that needs to be seen by everybody. If you watch this, if you are one of the few people who watch it, make it your responsibility to share it with everybody else. WhatsApp पे फालतू jokes भेजने से अच्छा है ये content भेजो, लोगों को समझाओ कि गाना क्या होता है, गाने को appreciate कैसे करते हैं और अच्छे artist को appreciate कैसे करते हैं. I have said this about everybody, with the people who got the millions of views and with people who don't. That if you like somebody's work, it's your responsibility to share that with others. It's your responsibility as a music lover, as a fan of music, to showcase that with others. It's like this: if you ate the best pani puri in the world, would you not go and put it up on Facebook or Instagram and say, "Arey yaar, aaj kya pani puri khaya? Isse acha pani puri khaya nahi hai." To yaar, jab acha gana sunte ho, usko bhi share karo na. Pani puri extra 5 rupees doge, bolenge, "Bhai, tune mere ko bahut khush kiya." That is the equivalent of putting a like or a comment under a video that you like. Do that. You love something. How can you not want to take your appreciation of that thing that gave you joy, that gave you peace of mind, by taking it a next step and giving that creator
sharing
that
it. Content, yes, true.
Yeah, that peace of mind and joy by saying, "Yaar, mala azun kahi nako hota. This is what I wanted. This all I ever wanted was that once somebody heard the song and they found it good, they shared it with somebody else, and that joy was
spread."
And the more you spread that joy, people will only thank you. If somebody gets a good song first thing in the morning, like your parents must be sending good morning messages of Ganpati or Krishna saying good morning. And why do they do that? Because it gives them joy in the morning. You send a good song to somebody in the morning, they will only praise you and say, "Yaar, this is something that started off my day on a good note." So please, if you love music, if you love somebody's work, share it with everybody else. That was the objective of asking him that question. True. And not making him uncomfortable about the fact, or me, that we don't have the numbers that everybody seems to be getting these days, you know.
I have started, in fact, another small series on my YouTube channel, and it's called Chanda Utha Tale, but it will have Hindi songs as well. The point is that, you know, most of the listeners listen to the finished product of a song. They listen to the song with all the paraphernalia, the singer's voice. So, but there is some different fun in listening to a song in its raw form when the music composer is singing. See,
lovely.
He might not be perfect, you know, like
correct,
a singer, but it's he knows the lanes and bylanes of that composition.
Absolutely.
So it's like listening to a finished product is going to Trivago and searching for a destination and the best price, and
correct,
listening to a song from the music composer is like taking a local guide and asking him ke yahan best pani puri, best golgappe, best bhel kahan milti hai, udhar leke chalo.
Correct.
So he'll take you into the... So this is the series I have started. 3 songs I have put up, mostly Marathi. And
I want to promise you, I know because of the way our life is structured, yours, mine, whoever else is, we don't get to meet very often. We don't get to talk very often. But I want to change that because I genuinely feel we are kindred spirits. From the first time we met, I also realize you're one of the few people who's actually been at my wedding. So that makes you like really special.
Yep. I remember.
Again, we must... Varshan pasun apan bolte ki kadhi kadhi ek gaana karaycha ekatra. Let's work on that eventually.
Let's work on that. Yeah.
Some point of time.
Best time is now.
Best time is now, exactly. And most importantly, I will be watching more of your content on YouTube, and I'm going to be sharing all the videos that I love. Thank you so much once again, Kaushal, for coming on the show.
Thank you.
It feels like 7 years went away like that, and it feels like we were just chatting a month ago or a few weeks ago or yesterday, and it feels brilliant to have you back on the show and to talk about everything that you've done ever since. I have nothing but love and respect for you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mihir. Thanks for having me.
For everybody who's watching, all of your fans who love your work, is there a message that you want to give before you leave?
Subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Yeah, that's the best thing. Absolutely. Yeah, please subscribe to his YouTube channel.
My Facebook page. I am doing something new every day.
Correct.
It's I'll tell you why I require listeners and why I require. It's, you know, Balgandharva, again, I'll invoke Balgandharva. He used to call them Rasik Maibap. They are parents. Why? Because an artist is incomplete without his listener.
Absolutely.
Only the listener gives the completion to any work of art, especially a performing art like a song. And it's not, it's like, it's only when you have a dialectic going on between the artist and the listener, then you take the art to a next level together.
I agree.
Yeah. And it's not only for the benefit of the artist, it's for the benefit of the listener as well.
I agree. Completely.
Like Bernard Shaw says, in a democracy, you will get the government you deserve. You will get the art you deserve. So if you interact with artists and if you interact with me, I'll be able to deliver better. So that is why I need you.
Well, absolutely. Please follow Kaushal on Facebook, on Twitter, here on Instagram as well. And most importantly, subscribe to his YouTube channel. Kaushal, please let everybody know that they should subscribe to the MJ Show as well, because it's been, I'll complete 7 years, like I said, on the 1st of August.
Yeah, I'll definitely say this because, you know, my interview on MJ Show is perhaps one of my most liked interviews. So I'll definitely ask people to share and subscribe to the MJ Show on YouTube as well. And you're, I am already following you on Twitter and Insta and Facebook.
Me too.
But I would also like people to see all your interviews for the fantastic content that you have generated, because it's not every day that a interviewer asks. You know, there is something like most of the interviewers can't scratch the surface of the artist. You manage to, you know, take out something totally unsaid, which I have not said before. And I believe that you must be doing that with all your artists, because I have heard your interview.
Thank you.
So please subscribe to Mihir's channel.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate the time that you spent with me and the kind words that you've said. And you know, I was just thinking about this a couple of days ago, because somebody asked me about this, and I said that there's a difference. I don't interview people, I have a conversation with them.
Yeah.
That's minute distinction between doing an interview and having a conversation. Because that's, I never, true. As you can see, I don't have any questions planned. There is nothing here. I want to get to know you better. I genuinely want to get to know you better.
And in that process of wanting
to getting to know you better, I'm sharing your story with the rest of the world. But it's my selfishness. It's my selfishness of wanting to get to know you better. And that selfishness is driving my content, and I'm able to create whatever I'm doing, because I just want, I genuinely enjoy meeting all the people who I meet on the show. Whether it's you or, like I said, a Sonu Nigam, a KK or a Monali Thakur or whoever has come on the show, it's been my joy to meet them. They are doing something I truly love and enjoy. True. And for me, that's getting to know them better. And that's why I've been able to. By the way, Instagram is telling me we've got 24 seconds left and Hamsika is here. Hamsika, the moment this gets over, we're going to start off again. I'm not taking a break. So you guys don't go anywhere as well. Kaushal, join us again. But this is all the time I have for now with the absolutely phenomenal Kaushal Inamdar. Thanks, Kaushal. I'm here. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.